Okay, so one of the topics is not enough faith to be an atheist. What were you saying about this was a book title?
Yeah, it's Norm Geisler and Frank Turek. I love the book. For anybody out there, I would definitely encourage, go check that thing out. I Don't Have Enough Faith to Be an Atheist by Norm Geisler and Frank Turek. They go through the 12 points that establish the truth of Christian faith.
Okay, so what kind of faith do I have since I'm an atheist? And you don't have this kind of faith. What's my faith that I'm not aware of?
In order to believe that the universe pops into existence out of nothing, or there's an infinite regress of dependent universes that you would call the multiverse with no evidence whatsoever, you got to have faith in that.
Okay,
you'd have to have faith that you have proteins, amino acids have to unite in the right order to make one protein. There's hundreds of proteins that operate each organelle to make them work. You have to have all the organelles in the right place, right time in cosmic history, all uniting together with the functional proteins. And then the proteins are going to be helping to build other proteins. And then you have to have the DNA all there at the same time with the base pairs with the information in there. The RNA has to be there. All of it has to be there simultaneously in order for it to work. You're not going to get that from mixing chemicals together. You're going to have a mind to do that. And so the origin of life is an issue. The fact that the universe exists. Like, would you say atheism is true, therefore we would expect there to be a universe? Would you say
no? I think, like I said earlier, I think we're just too naive to even draw any kind of conclusions. We only know 4% of the universe, which is matter and energy. 96% is dark energy, dark matter, and we are clueless. I don't think we can make any kind of estimate. But hold on a second. I think when you do make these estimates, you use deductive logic and stuff like that to make these decisions about there must be a God. I think it goes into a category of, quote, pretending to know things you don't.
No, it would be philosophically deduced.
From nothing, though. I mean, you can't philosophically deduce stuff if you're in the dark. I could say, like, can you philosophically deduce?
I don't have to know about the universe. All I have to know is existence. I have direct access to the laws of existence right now. I don't need to know all about the corners of the universe.
I know you don't have to know about everything, but when you only know about 4% about something, that is totally insufficient to say, therefore this is a justified, reasonable conclusion.
I have direct access to existence right now. The fact that I exist, I got my existence from another, but whatever made me, if it got its existence from another, it can't go on forever. There's got to be something that didn't get its existence from another and is just identical to existence. It's pure actuality, no potential, can't change.
But that just goes back to the Big Bang. And then that was the start say that was the start of time and space.
It would be prior to the Big Bang.
What's that?
It would be prior to the Big Bang.
Well, there was to the Big Bang. If time started at the Big Bang, there was no prior.
Not temporally prior. We're talking about ontologically prior.
What's the difference? Tell me what the difference is.
Well, one would be temporally. One would be in being.
There's no difference.
No, there. Here's the difference. Like we would not say God has existed for an infinite number of days. That God, from the divine mind perspective, experiences everything in one act, in one moment. That God doesn't have parts. God's not divisible. He's not complex. He would be what we call simple. That in one act of God's mind, he knows all things. He is all existing. That time exists in God or in existence. The universe has a beginning because it's temporal. But something has to be ontologically prior to the universe. And right now, why do you exist right now? Why don't you just... I mean, the universe doesn't have to be here because at one time it wasn't here, so it's unnecessary. So why doesn't it just disappear now?
It could. Who knows? Maybe there's a multiverse and another one's going to bump into us and wipe us out. Who knows?
Well, your multiverse ends up being the uncaused, infinite, eternal, non-changing, pure actual being.
Well, again, I don't like you using the word being. I would prefer you say thing, because being implies you're trying to stretch it into being God.
Well, God is a person, but it doesn't have to mean that.
This whole thing of God, how could this whole thing of God and time doesn't make any sense? I mean, it's like you know, supposedly God is supposed to know everything in the future, past, present, future, everything. Mm-hmm. Why would he even bother making anything when he already knows what's going to happen? I mean, I say that would be total torture, because it's bad enough to watch a movie 100 times, but if you had to watch it a zillion times and he knows every second what's going to happen at every moment, at every angle, that'd be torture to have to go through it. Why would he do that?
Yeah, that would be a category mistake to take. It was boring to us, to him. Plus, God does this for you and me.
No, he doesn't. He doesn't do this for me and you. What about all those little miscarried babies? How come he didn't do it for them?
He is granting you existence right now.
Come on. What's so special about me and not these miscarried babies?
Well, they're special too. I mean, that doesn't mean that they're not special. I mean,
well, they don't have existence. They don't have existence.
Well, they, assuming that they are still existing in the divine mind right now, but not here on earth, that their form, their soul is still with him.
What are these little infants doing in heaven?
Don't know. I've never been there.
Does it make any sense that there's little infants in heaven? I mean, what kind of a mind is that?
I mean, there's infants on earth. I mean, why so they can't be in heaven? I don't know that they would be infants there. I don't know.
The infants on earth are growing, and they're growing their brains. They're learning. Right. They're configuring their brains. Everything's growing, and they're learning.
Yes, as they're existing in God.
Right, but there's no such thing as like their real essence that is being revealed or something like that. They just are. So if they're a miscarried fetus, it's like, what are they supposed to be doing? Growing in heaven? I mean, it just seems ludicrous.
Can you right now imagine a miscarried being in heaven right now? Can you imagine that?
No, it seems like nonsense.
I mean, you don't have the ability to picture it.
I mean, it seems like a fetus in heaven. I can picture it, I guess, but...
It doesn't have to be a fetus. It can be a developed being brought into a mature existence in heaven. You can picture that, can't you?
A matured existence?
Yeah. Like I don't know that they're going to be a fetus in heaven. I don't know why you're...
Well, there's no such thing as a matured existence for a fetus.
Well, no, kind of like Adam and Eve were mature creations. They were brought into existence as
right,
mature
right.
Adults.
And that's all total nonsense to think like, here's God made this human person, and they already knew how to speak without being taught. They already knew how to think without being taught. I mean, all this stuff is just crazy.
One time I was in I did martial arts, and I got kicked in the head, and I got amnesia. And it was the weirdest thing. I did not know my name, but I knew what a name was. I didn't know my phone number, but I knew what they meant when they asked me what my phone number was. And it was weird. It was like I was brought into existence, and I did not know why I had the little outfit on. It was not until my mom showed up that my memory started coming back to me. And so I kind of imagined that that's kind of what Adam would have been like, that he could think, but probably language had to develop. In other words, I can kind of relate somewhat because of that experience. What that may have been like.
Well, we're going to have to end it with there. We're out of time. So appreciate the conversation. It's been interesting.
Yes. Yeah.